Welcome back to the check-in. My name is Jarrett, and I'm here with Colby to talk more about solo miners. And I was asking Colby before we got on this, hey, how do you want to structure this conversation? And he says, quote, I will surprise you. So hopefully everyone's ready to be surprised. The question we are going to be tackling here is, what is the best solo miner? Now, this may be subjective or objective. This could be a subjective thing depending upon other factors like your budget. This could be subjective compared to your power rate, if that is an actual concern. Some people have really high power rates and people have lower power rates. Some people want to run like 10 bit axes, as maybe you've seen on X. But I'm excited to throw the mic to Colby. Colby is an avid solo miner. Colby, what is the best solo miner? Break this down.
I would say that the best solo miner is the solo miner that you actually have online. And that is a little bit of a dig at you for not getting a power supply unit.
Oh, it's a dig. I felt it deep in my Satoshi soul.
For your Avalon Nano, that thing's just been sitting around producing zero hash, and I took that personally last time we spoke.
Yeah.
And meanwhile, this bad boy's been hashing away. I unplugged it just for the sake of this video.
You took it offline.
I did. Why'd you do that? I took it briefly offline, and hopefully that's not when it would have hit a block.
You just would have hit a block.
Ouch. So, you know, at the end of the day, the best solo mining hash is the hash that you actually have hashing. And we can get into different efficiencies and different power draws and different designs and whatnot. But I think that at the end of the day, if you've got some solo mining hash online, then good for you, because you stand a chance to actually get some Bitcoin.
That is a great answer. Thank you for the burn. Now I know why you didn't want to tell me before we recorded. Let's do a hypothetical. Let's say you have, or someone comes to you and they're like, hey, I have $250 and I want to get into solo mining. What are the miners you would, you know, push them towards? I was going to say, where would you have them go? What would be the best avenue? Because for $250, I think the Brains one you got was a little bit more than that. I know my Avalon Nano 3 it's $100 up on the Canaan website. What would you have them do? Is that where you want to just get into bit axes and say, hey, with all that, you can get enough material between the chips and the fans and everything that you would need to put together solo miners where you could get more hash online for that money? What would be your advice?
Interesting question. And, you know, if you're going to build your own bit axe, that's probably going to take you a lot of time. So there are people that are prefabricating the bit axes and they will ship it to you, and you can get your hands on one for, you know, as little as $100 if you wanted to get into something like a bit axe ultra. In any case, I don't think there's one right way to go about it. I think that much of it is up to personal preference. Like, for example, this is not the most efficient solo miner that you can possibly get your hands on, but I think the BMM 100 or the 101 is really cool because it's got this metal enclosure and it just looks sick sitting on my desk. And it also displays some cool data on the screen, Bitcoin price, block height, and a bunch of other information as well. And a lot of these solar miners have different profiles, right? The BitAxe looks totally different than the BMM 100 or the Avalon Nano 3. They're different machines, but hash is hash. So, you know, if you can get 1 terahash or 500 gigahash or, you know, more online, then that's awesome. Obviously, the more hash you have online, the greater chance you have of actually hitting a block. And something I wanted to refer to is this solo chance. There's solochance.org or solochance.com, which actually helps you calculate your chances of hitting a block solo mining. So for example, if you've only got 1 terahash online at current difficulty and current network hash rate of about 679 exahash, that means that 1 terahash has about 1 in 679 million every block of hitting a block. So you have about a 1 in 679 million chance per block, which equates to about 1 in 4.7 million per day. and we can calculate weekly or monthly from there.
So you're saying there's a chance?
That's exactly what I'm saying.
Well, I think that was a great answer. I think the best soul miner is the one that is online. Thank you for the sweet burn. And I also think that there are a lot of different options in that hypothetical where you do have $250 or you come into a couple hundred bucks and you're like, how can I get some hash online? If you have some extra time and you do have some ingenuity and you like putting stuff together, I think BitAx is a great way to go. Otherwise, as Colby's called out, the BMM 100, I have the Avalon Nano 3, and there's other products online out there, you know, you can find that are going to just give it to you all in one. And they've got a nice, you know, display screen where you can stay up to date on stuff. So this has been great because I think that that's a question that people are constantly asking. Hey, what is the best solo miner out there? If you're watching this on YouTube, please subscribe. Listen to this on a podcast platform. Make sure you're following us on LinkedIn, X, and YouTube at Compass Mining. And Colby, thank you once again for hopping on the check-in.
Happy hashing, folks. Thanks, Jarrett.